The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Welcome, friends. Happy birthday. This is the birthday of the church. Happy Pentecost to you and welcome. I'm Laura Smith Conrad, pastor of Fort Hill Church, and I want to welcome friends and guests and all those worshiping with us out in God's world, wherever you are. There is a pad in our pews inside the sanctuary. If you would make your presence known and let us know how we can contact you and include you in our church family, we would love to reach out. Today, as we celebrate the birthday of the church, we also receive a gift. We receive the gift of Christ in communion as we celebrate the Lord's Supper today. So just to remind you, we continue to use our sanitary little cups here. They'll be passed to you in the pews. At the end of service, there is a trash can, a receptacle for your cups after service. Also, following service, you might pick up a devotional, if you haven't already, for the coming week as we walk with Jesus and walk with Pastor Mary on her Sabbath journey as we enjoy the beauty of creation and the ways that God speaks to us throughout the world. So take one home with you and use that as a tool for your spiritual growth and discernment as well. And finally, on a sad note, I want to make you aware of the death of Tiffany Deal's grandmother. Tiffany is a newer member who's joined in the last year. Her grandmother, Billy Painter in Clover, died on Tuesday. So let us remember Tiffany Deal and her family in prayer. And now, friends, let us unite our hearts in worship as we worship together.
As you stand, let us stand together and call ourselves to worship. Wild and free, creative and refreshing, God's Spirit blows through this place.
Come, Holy Spirit.
Gentle and mysterious, patient and caring, God's Spirit moves in our hearts.
Come, Holy Spirit.
Breaking barriers and making connections, healing divisions and making us one, God's Spirit flows between us.
Come, Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
Please be seated. Our Lord Jesus said, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the greatest and first commandment, and second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments hang all the law of the prophets." As God has instructed us in these great commandments, and because we have not lived in full obedience, let us now confess our sins to God, trusting Christ as our Savior and our Lord. Let us pray. God of fire and wind, holy and powerful, mighty and mysterious, we are drawn by your Spirit to this place. As we gather and behold your glory, we become aware of our sin. We have ignored your word. We have rejected your gifts. We have failed in your work, ignoring the truth of Pentecost. We exclude those different from us. We divide our loyalties, and we divide our hearts. Let your Spirit burn away our sins and fill us with faith and courage, so that we might live into the promise of this day and receive the fullness of all that you have prepared for us in Jesus Christ. Amen. Friends, hear this good news. God has compassion on us. God, through the name of Jesus Christ, says you are forgiven, strengthening us to bring the good news into the world. Friends, in the name of Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. Thanks be to God. Now, in the knowledge of that forgiveness, let us share the peace of Christ with one another. The peace of Christ be with you all.
And also with you.
Please share a sign of peace.
Good morning, boys and girls. Good morning. Y'all have to turn your heads to look at me. I'm going to come right here so you can see something. I have a special bag with some things in it, and I want you to tell me what happens with this thing. What does this do? What, Addie? You shake it when somebody says, "Alleluia." Hey, yeah. Just like that? Nice. What does this do? Does anybody know what this does? It's Flat Mary. Yes, it is Flat Mary. What does it do? Yes. And what does it make happen? Wind. Okay, good job. Y'all are catching on. What does this do?
You blow it.
Ah. Caleb, you want to give it a shot? Can you blow on it? What about you, Hudson? No? Addie? Oh, look at there. it do that by itself? It can? How does that do that by itself? The wind? Does this fan move by itself? Does that move by itself? What does it take to make it happen? Wind? Yourself? Something's got to make it move. Yes, Caleb. Wind. So all these things have that in common. They make wind, but they can't do it by themselves, can they? There's a power called wind that makes it happen. Or us, breath. But I could do this. Woo! So something has to move it. That's right. This is a little science experiment. I'm a humanities major, but I'm married to a science person. So I learned these things from him. And what it reminds me is today is Pentecost. It's a special Sunday when we remember that a special power came into the world through the church. Do you know what that power is called? Wind and
fire
and love and the Holy Spirit. Has anybody ever heard of the Holy Spirit? Raise your hand if you've heard of the Holy Spirit. Anybody here? Okay, we've heard of it. Well, the Holy Spirit is the thing, the power of God that makes things move. Could you live without breathing? Hold your breath just for a second. Ready? One, two, three. Oh. You can't live without breath, just like we can't live without God. God's Spirit fills us up, gives us energy and power and peace, and today is the day we celebrate that. We call this the birthday of the church. Have you ever heard that? The birthday of the church? And so we receive a wonderful gift called the Holy Spirit. So today, after worship, after you go to your time together, or you sit with your mom or your dad, and you come up after church, I want you to take a pinwheel home with you to remember. That's your birthday present. That's your birthday present to remember the power of God. Jesus said, I'm going away, but I'm going to leave my Spirit with you. And that reminds us that God is always with us. The Holy Spirit lives and dwells among us. And every time we experience the power of wind or the breath we breathe, we remember what? God is with us. Can you pray with me? Dear God, we thank you for this day.
We thank you for this day.
For loving us in every way.
For loving us.
Help us to love,
and
not to fuss,
because we know that you love us.
Thank you for your Spirit.
Thank you for your Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Thanks, boys and girls.
Our Old Testament scripture this morning comes from the book of Genesis, from the 11th chapter. Let us open our hearts and minds to hearing God's word. Now the whole earth had one language and the same words. And as they migrated from the east, they came upon a plain in the land of Shinar and settled there. And they said to one another, come, let us make bricks and burn them thoroughly. And they had brick for stone and bitumen for mortar. Then they said, come, let us build ourselves a city and a tower with its top in the heavens. Let us make a name for ourselves. Otherwise, we shall be scattered abroad upon the face of the whole earth. The Lord came down to see the city and the tower which mortals had built. And the Lord said, look, they are one people, and they have one language. And this is only the beginning of what they will do. Nothing that they propose to do will now be impossible for them. Come, let us go down and confuse their language there, so that they will not understand one another's speech. So the Lord scattered them abroad from there over the face of all the earth. And they left off building the city. Therefore, it was called Babel, because there the Lord confused the language of all the earth. And from there, the Lord scattered them abroad over the face of all the earth. Friends, this is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
On the mountain, my Lord spoke. Out of his mouth came fire and smoke. Don't look around me, it looks so fine, till I ask my Lord if all was mine. Jordan River is chilly and cold. It chills the body, but not the soul. There ain't but one trail upon this track. It leads to heaven and right back.
Every time I
prepare to hear God's word in the New Testament from the book of Acts 2. Let us pray. O living God, you have created all that is. Send forth your spirit to renew and restore us, that we may proclaim your good news in ways and in words, that others will understand and believe. But more than just tell it, help us also to listen to your spirit and to the people around us, so we may know and experience the power of your presence and the fire of your love. Amen. I'll be reading from Acts 2, that first Pentecost Sunday. When the day of Pentecost had come, they were all together in one place. And suddenly from heaven there came a sound like the rush of a violent wind. And it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues of fire appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages as the Spirit gave them ability. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem, and at this sound the crowd gathered and was bewildered, because each one heard them speaking in the native language of each. Amazed and astonished, they asked, "Are not all these who are speaking Galileans? And how is that we hear each of us in our own native tongue? Parthians, Medes, Elamites, and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt, and all the parts of Libya belonging to Cyrene, and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs, in our own languages, we hear them speaking about God's deeds of power. All were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, "What does this mean?" But others sneered and said, "They are filled with new wine." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. In both scripture readings today, we learn that peoples have always tried to divide and distinguish themselves in different ways by language, nationality. Our society, we may notice, is racked sometimes with the fear of others, those who might be different. Recently, we learned that a shooter at a Buffalo grocery store subscribed to a belief that white people are being replaced by persons of color, so he shot up a grocery store in a predominantly black neighborhood. Fear of difference, differences which God designed and created, can be the root of such acts. Hateful language and ideas infect us like a disease. Today, we read in Genesis that God confused the speech of the people and made them differently. We see this in all of God's created order, not only in the varieties of species, but even within a species. We just look around at the people beside us. We're all a little different, aren't we? Or listen to the different songs of birds. Or notice the varieties of trees in the forest. What beauty God has wrought in this world. 2 weeks ago, all the South Carolina Presbyteries gathered at Presbyterian College, and I realized again that our church is diverse and rich and beautiful. I was reminded of that as men and women and young and old and black and white led us in worship. We sang God's praise together, and we witnessed God's blessings in that community and in communion together. It wasn't quite like that first Pentecost, but for me, it was a glimpse of the reign of God, that vision that God gives us. But it was that first Pentecost where a rich variety of people gathered, probably about 120 men and women gathering for worship and fellowship. They were just 7 weeks away from the resurrection of Jesus, whom they continued to follow. And they remembered that Jesus promised them the Holy Spirit. And that's when it happens. They experience that promise. And the Spirit of God descends upon them. And then they begin to speak about God's mighty deeds. And they all understood one another. And that good news. This is the day that we remember that the Holy Spirit was unleashed on the church, the gathered people of God. Don't you just love that experience? You see, Jews from all over, speaking different languages, have gathered. They were told by Jesus that they would get to be witnesses, and then God makes it possible. God reminds us that the Spirit is always working and creating a kingdom of God reality, one that is more rich and expansive and diverse than just a small band of disciples. You never know what God might be up to. But this is not the first time that God uses language. We read in Genesis about the descendants of Noah building that Tower of Babel. Language is important here too. Did you hear the story? People want to build a great city of bricks along with this tower so they can stay put, have the same language, and develop a reputation. a name for themselves. But God has something different in mind. God confuses their language, making them unable to finish that task. And then God scatters them. Who were they? Scripture says the children of Adam, our ancestor. Adam, you know it means dirt, earth, dust. The children of the earth take dirt in hand and fashion bricks. But God intervenes, and God sets limits on the human race. These children of Adam and scatters them, creating different cultures and different languages. God sets a design for humanity and sets limits on us, reminding us, I hate to tell you, we are not God. We are limited human beings. And God orders culture and languages to have variety and interest. And while they were wanting to make a name for themselves, God has another idea. All people will know my name, the great I am. I am God. You are not. And then on that first Christian Pentecost, God used that wonderful variety of language to birth a church that they could not even imagine. And what does it all mean, they ask. Well, Peter tells them. He tells them what the prophet Joel had said. I'll pour out my spirit upon all flesh, all humanity. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your young men shall see visions. Your old men dream dreams. Everyone who calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. The people who want to make a name for themselves, well, they will be put to use so that all might know the name of the Lord, the God of Israel, revealed most fully in Christ Jesus. But God is doing something else there. God is creating a reality of the reign of God. Because God, you know, God gets everything God wants. And God wants to create that beautiful intended blessing and peace we see first in creation, in Eden's garden. So do you see the connection between the stories of our people? The confused language of the earth gets put to use at Pentecost to bring God's name before everyone. And it's the work of the Holy Spirit. And now they will see that there is one God, maker of heaven and earth, one God, one people, with differences and distinctions. And now they'll know we are all children of God. What was confused at Babel? Well, it's now understood. And God creates this counter-cultural community, the Church of Jesus Christ. But both scripture stories remind us that words matter. Speech can create, speech can destroy. God used speech to create. Let there be light, and there was. And you know what? It was good. But also listening, understanding, as those first Christians did, that heals and creates connection and builds bridges. One commentator wrote this for us today as we are Pentecost people. Something happens when we speak each other's languages, be they cultural, political, racial, liturgical. We experience the limits of our own perspectives. We learn curiosity, and we discover that God's great deeds, well, they're too far nuanced for just one single tongue. So what is the Spirit saying to the people, to us? Maybe that we live in a world where words can become toxic, where the languages of our cherished isms threaten to divide or destroy, and that the troubles of our day cry out for the balm of a bold and creative church willing to engage across barriers. And that if we don't learn the art of speaking each other's language, we'll burn ourselves down. It's no small thing, then, that the Holy Spirit loosed the tongues on the birthday of the church. In the face of all those differences, God compelled God's people to engage. From day one, the call was to press in and linger and listen. And listen some more. Friends, this Wednesday, 10 pilgrims will be traveling to Israel, the land of three major Abrahamic faiths and centuries of conflict. We are going to lean in, to listen, and to learn. Pilgrims go with the hope that God is going to teach us something through others and through God's larger world, this world that God loves. So I invite you all who are not going with us to remember in prayer Anne Marie Alexander and Carol Pollock and Rhonda Noel, Helen Wooten and Jane Thomas, Cynthia Warner, Ethel and Steve Pettigrew, and Chuck Conrad and me. If you're here, raise your hand. These are the people to remember and pray for. Next week, we'll be in Jerusalem, that place of the Pentecost church birth. And I imagine we'll be surrounded by many people speaking many different languages. But just before we get there, we'll visit Jaffa, that famed city, Joppa, where Jonah refused to go because he thought those people were beyond God's grace. Jaffa. It's where Peter had this vision of clean and unclean animals, and the Holy Spirit changed Peter's mind. He now understood that Gentiles were included in the covenant of God's grace and love. Today in Jaffa, there's a bakery that brings me hope. Perhaps we could learn something from them in our polarized communities and nation. You see, after a particularly volatile conflict, this popular Arab bakery frequented by Jewish and Arab customers changed their employees' uniforms to a t-shirt that read, "Jews and Arabs refuse to be enemies." On the back of the t-shirt, they put symbols of the cross and the crescent and the Star of David. The bakery has been baking bread since 1879 in this ancient port city of Jaffa. It's a multicultural town where Muslims and Christians and Jews continue to live side by side. And the bakery said this in an article, "We've been around long enough to know that nothing but coexistence is the solution to this conflict." You see, bread, well, it brings people together. And Jesus, friends, is our bread of life. His is a ministry of reconciliation and peace. And so it is our ministry and mission, too. So wherever you go this week, even across the street or across town, listen, listen to the Holy Spirit. Listen and be open to what we might learn from one another, and especially from those outside our group or our community. Because if we've learned one thing about God, it's that God is always doing a new thing. So may we have the ears and the eyes to perceive it. Amen.
If you are able, I would invite you to stand, and together let us lift our voices as we affirm what we believe using these words from the Belhar Confession. We believe that Christ's work of reconciliation is made manifest in the church as the community of believers who have been reconciled with God and with one another. We believe that unity is, therefore, both a gift and an obligation for the Church of Jesus Christ, that through the working of God's Spirit, it is a binding force, yet simultaneously a reality which must be earnestly pursued and sought, one which the people of God must continually be built up to attain.
Church is on foundation. Jesus Christ, your Lord. Good morning.
Good morning.
My name is Cindy Trammell, and I am the moderator of the membership ministry. So the Great Commission is recorded in Matthew 28, 18 through 20. All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations. I want to thank all of you for being such good disciples. In the last 2 years, in the middle of a pandemic, we have welcomed over 50 new members plus 17 confirmands. Give yourselves a round of applause for growing our church. We are growing, and we are growing in the Holy Spirit and in God's name. So continue to invite your friends. Our next Discovering Faith Luncheon will be July 24th with an opportunity to join Fort Hill on July 31st. I'll be at the front if we have any visitors with us today who would like to learn more about Fort Hill and more about opportunities to become engaged in our body of Christ. So, God calls upon us to love one another as God loves us. Even as God has abundantly blessed us with good things, let us bless others through gifts that show we care. Thank you for your faithful gifts online and through the mail. You may also give today by placing your offering in the basket out in the narthex as you exit today. Thank you for being faithful servants.
Friends, Jesus came into this world to break down the dividing walls that humans build. He is our peace and reconciles us to God and to one another. Jesus, he was absolutely obsessed with the kingdom of God, wasn't he? The reign of the one who made and loves this world. And he gave to us a ministry of reconciliation. But he did not leave us to our own devices. He gathers us, he teaches us, he feeds us, and he blesses us at this table of grace. Jesus invites those who trust him to come and be filled to the brim with his life and spirit, so we might go forth to bless, break, give, and receive the goodness of God.
Let us pray. Loving God, you created us in your image and breathed the breath of life into us, calling us your children and promising to always be our God. We turned to sin, and yet you were always faithful to your promises, loving us enough to send your only Son to live among us and then to die for us. Even as Christ ascended to be with you, you did not leave us to fend for ourselves, but you sent your Spirit on that first Pentecost to be your ongoing presence in our lives, making sure we knew that you were always with us, no matter where we go or what happens in our lives or in the world around us. For these and your many other blessings, we pause and offer our prayers of thanksgiving to you. Especially this morning, we thank you that on the night of his arrest and trials preceding his death, Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, then shared it with his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body broken for you." We also thank you for the way he took the cup, the new covenant sealed in his blood and shed for the forgiveness of sins, and shared it with his disciples, saying, "Whenever you eat and drink, do this in remembrance of me." As we gather this morning and worship you, we also pray for the world around us, praying for the end of all wars, for the healing of those who suffer, for comfort for those who mourn, for new life in your creation which has suffered and been abused and ignored. Through the power of your Spirit, unite us with Christ and with one another as we work and wait in hope confident that Christ will come again, making all things well, and gathering all of us together around his heavenly table. These prayers we lift to you in the name of the one who taught us how to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Our Lord, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread. And after giving thanks, as we have done, in his name he broke it. And he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body, broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me.
In the same way, Jesus took the cup, saying, This cup is the new covenant sealed in my blood, shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do so in remembrance of me. Friends, every time we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim Christ's saving death until he comes again. And indeed, he will come. Thanks be to God for the gifts of God. Would the servers come forward?
Thank you.
Let us pray. Holy God, by the gift of your Spirit, you have nourished us and filled us. Now send us out to share the vision of new creation you have begun. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Serve the world, and may all your living and breathing and being, may you find yourself filled to the brim with the Holy Spirit, and may the Spirit change us for the transformation of the world. Go forth in the name of the one who created you in love, the one who redeemed you by the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and in the power of the Holy Spirit this day and each day. Amen.
Amen.